It's that time of the year again. If you want to tighten your tummy for summer, then this video is for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. You're watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails. Just tell me what works. And this is my fat loss plan for you. If you want to lose weight and you want to lose weight reliably, then you need a caloric deficit. It's plain and simple. But when you want to lose weight, what you really mean is you want to lose fat. And if you want to lose fat mass instead of lean mass, there's really three things that you need to keep in mind. Number one is you don't want to lose weight too rapidly. I think the sweet spot is about a pound a week. It's going to vary from person to person. I wouldn't get too wrapped up in losing exactly that. If it's a half a pound a week or it's a pound and a half to 2 pounds a week, I think that's okay, but no more than 2 pounds a week. The second thing you want to keep in mind is that you need an exercise program that provides an anabolic stimulus to convince your body that it's worth keeping your muscle mass, because muscle mass is energetically expensive to maintain. And if you are losing weight, you're losing your energy stores, and you're not telling your body that muscle mass is really important, it's going to say, hey, if I just cut out this muscle mass, I don't need as much energy. The third thing is you got to eat enough protein. If you don't eat enough protein, then it doesn't matter if your body thinks that there's a reason to maintain the muscle mass. Your body's not going to have the resources needed to maintain that muscle mass. When it comes to carbs or fat, I don't really think it matters in terms of weight loss or fat mass loss. I think you want to control your calories and you want to target your protein to about a gram of protein per target body weight. Meaning, what do you want to weigh at the end of your weight loss? Whatever that is in pounds, eat that many grams of protein. If you're eating a more carb-heavy diet, you can probably get away more easily with restricting the protein below that. If you're eating a lower carb diet, you're gonna have to try to hit that protein mark because carbohydrates can spare the need for protein in ways that fat can't. Now, when you're doing this, I think what you should generally do is ride out your weight loss for 3 to 4 months. I think most of the time after the 4 month mark, it's really time to give your body a rest because weight loss is stressful on the body. Speaking of stress, you can imagine your stress as a bucket. It doesn't matter if weight loss is part of the stress or pregnancy is part of the stress or working all the time is part of the stress or your family is part of the stress. All your stresses go into that bucket. The fuller that bucket is, the less room you have for other stressors. So if you got a lot going on, if you got a lot of mental, emotional, whatever it is, if your stress bucket is getting full, take time to manage your stress bucket to make room for weight loss before you put weight loss in that bucket. That's what I did in 2015. At the beginning of 2016, I lost 30 pounds in 4 months using this technique. So let's dig right into it. Some people will say that you should calculate how many calories you should be consuming. I think that's okay, but honestly, I think you can skip that part. I think it's better to collect baseline data about the amount of calories you are consuming when you're not losing any weight. And that's because you have to guess about how active you really are. You have to guess about how intense your exercise really is. You have to guess about how much you fidget and what your basal level of metabolism is. It's too much guesswork for those formulas to be accurate. So what we'll do in the first week is just collect baseline data. We want to know our body weight from day to day, and we want to know how many calories we're eating, without trying to lose any weight. For the body weight, you want the conditions to be as similar as possible from day to day to reduce unneeded variation. So get up in the morning, go to the bathroom, pee, take off all your clothes, and weigh yourself naked after you've peed and use that as your body weight for the day. Do that each morning for a week and verify that you've remained weight stable. Also, find a way that works for you to track your calories. I use my Fitness Pal, and in the next video, I'll show you how I do that. But find something that works for you and track your calories from day to day. At the end of the week, you want to look at this data. You want to verify you've remained weight stable, but you also want to look at the variation up and down each day. To be weight stable means to be weight stable on average. Your body weight may go up a pound, down a pound, up 2 pounds, down 2 pounds. You want a sense of that variation so that you're not tricked by that level of variation later when you're actually trying to lose weight. You want to take your average calorie consumption for that week and take that as the calories that you assume make you weight stable. For the second week, continue weighing yourself and continue tracking your calories, but induce a 500 calorie per day deficit. Do that consistently for a week. Don't worry if your weight goes up or down from day to day, just collect the data. At the end of the second week, you want to look at your weight at the end of the week. If your weight goes up and down a lot, then take the lowest value from the last couple days of the week. Compare it to your average weight for the first week and see if you've lost weight. Ideally, you should have lost at least a half a pound and about a pound, give or take. You also want to look at how do you feel? You want to feel better. If you feel tired all the time or anxious or you have trouble sleeping or you're irritable or you're hangry, you want to take that into account. If you've lost a good amount of weight and you feel great, just keep doing what you're doing and continue to track your calories and your weight over the course of 3 to 4 months. And only tweak the plan if you start to plateau before that time is up. On the other hand, if you're not losing weight, increase the caloric deficit from 500 to 700. Or, conversely, if you're losing weight but you feel bad, you're having trouble sleeping, you're getting hangry, you're getting irritable, etc., then decrease the caloric deficit from 500 calories to 300 calories. Repeat that after the week and tweak as needed until you find the sweet spot that allows continued and sustained weight loss, but also allows you to feel good. During the course of your weight loss, remember to eat 1 gram of protein per pound of target body weight, and remember to keep up with your exercise program. If you want to retain your lean muscle mass, just do online research about bodybuilding approaches to exercise. The approaches that are going to maximize the building of muscle for someone in a caloric excess are the same exercises that are going to help you keep on to your muscle in a caloric deficit. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com. You've been watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next video.